is Annie Clark, aka St Vincent, and we're here at the Somerset House, and we just saw the Isabella Blow exhibition. Isabella Blow's contribution to it all was, I guess, not just a muse, but also a collaborator. I think muse is a little bit of a bummer of a place to be, because you aren't creative yourself. You're just a spark for someone else. But it sounds like she was really a collaborator and someone with great ideas who found the right people to implement those great ideas. My favorite pieces in the exhibition, there was one outfit that was a dress, this red dress with a blue and a floral snake-like pattern that was really beautiful, but it was coupled with a helmet with just a little slit for the eyes, helmet that probably went to about here. And I just love the idea of showing up to a dinner party kind of looking like a 60s housewife, but with, you're ready for battle. I'm sure some of the dinner parties she went to, I'm sure she needed something like that. I also loved the hat that was like a Bridget Riley op art hat, like almost like a hypnosis hat. If you look at it too closely, you'll get hypnotized. I thought that was really great. And then there was another wonderful hat that was transparent, peachy red plexiglass that just went, basically covered all of her face except had a little little space for her nose and mouth. I thought that was excellent. I would totally wear them. Lady Gaga has all that shit on, like, on lockdown, so it's kind of scary territory, I think, but it's epically awesome. I make music predominantly. It's nice to be able to introduce a visual language surrounding a project so that not so that it overpowers the music, but so that it augments it. So I was really inspired by a lot of the color and the whimsy and the sense of humor in it. I like the fact that fashion is wearable art, you know, at its highest form. And I don't mean highest form like, oh, you have to go and spend a gazillion dollars on it. I just mean when it really gets to be an expression of an extension of who you are and a piece of wearable art. That's the best way.